Bacteria. Bad, ugly and good. Hi guys, welcome to the kingdom of bacteria. Let us explore the kingdom that is full of these tiny creatures together. We will not always see them, but they eventually exist in this world along with the humans. Normally, a lot of people think that bacteria are bad creatures. In fact, there's a lot of good bacteria that helps humans to survive even better. It sounds crazy, right? But trust me, it's true. Let me introduce you to the bad, ugly and the good side of bacteria. Come on, follow me. Oh no! He has eaten some undercooked meat, and causes them to have diarrhea. We cannot see these tiny, bad creatures in the meat with our naked eyes, but actually, they are in there. This is because a meat that is not well cooked, allows the survival of bad bacteria. And, causes a boy to have diarrhea after eating it. Campylobacter, which is known as the most common bacteria, that is found in raw, or undercooked meat. This bacteria, is also known as the global cause of diarrheal diseases. They are usually carried in the animals such as, in the intestines, liver, and other organs. It can be transferred, to other edible parts, when an animal is slaughtered. Therefore, to kill these bad bacteria, we need to have proper meal preparation, to ensure, the meat is cooked thoroughly before being served. Here's another cool bacteria that could make humans even miserable. Vibrio cholerae, is a bacterium that can cause cholera, a life-threatening infectious disease to humans. Over 100,000 people died from cholera each year, but never fear, with proper treatment, 99% of patients would survive. Cholera is an acute diarrheal infection that is caused by ingesting dirty water or food contaminated by this nasty bacteria.
Between 12 hours and 5 days after ingesting the contaminated food or water, the symptoms start to show. Most people tend to have diarrhea, which can cause dehydration. If the patient is untreated, the diarrhea results in severe dehydration, and can lead to death. However, it can be treated with clean water and rehydration sachets to ensure the patients stay hydrated. This is a low-cost treatment. For some severe cases, they might need antibiotics and intravenous fluids to keep the control of dehydration. The bad bacteria do not own this world solely. Do you know? There are some ugly bacterias too. They are not as bad as the bad bacteria, as they do not cause human serious sickness. The ugly ones play with your food and eventually cause foods to go bad and gross. Here, the spoiled foods are actually caused by the overgrown of many lactic acid bacteria and anaerobic bacteria. Although these bacteria are not harmful, the waste products, which is the acid produced by it, will turn the food bad.
Isn't that disgusting? Because of the bacteria, it brings the ugly side on the food, making it to become so gross, and might even make humans sick.
Hey, don't worry. As there are also many kinds of good bacteria that bring goodness to humans. For example, many products are manufactured with the help of good bacteria. Come on, let me show you. Do you know what can be found in the yogurt?
Oh, let me guess, is it bacteria?
Yes, you are right. The yogurt is made up of milk, with the addition of some good bacteria such as lactobacillus. It's made under suitable conditions, to allow only the good bacteria to grow. Let us see how yogurt is made. Firstly, all equipment is sterilized to kill any unwanted bacteria or other microbes. After sterilization, the milk is heated to a temperature of around 85 to 95 degrees Celsius, for 15 to 30 minutes to kill bacteria that are found in the milk. This process is known as pasteurization. The third step is homogenization, During this step, the milk is broken down into fat droplets and becomes smaller. This makes them suspended in yogurt. After that, the milk is cooled down to around 40 to 45 degrees Celsius. Now, the starter cultures, lactic acid bacteria such as Streptococcus thermophilus and Lactobacillus species are added. These bacteria break down the lactose into lactic acid. They also digest the milk protein. The mixture is fermented at 40 to 45 degrees Celsius. Lactic acid bacteria works best at this temperature range. Fermentation produces lactic acid and causes the pH to drop to 4.4, which is why the yogurt tastes sour. At such a low pH, lactic acid bacteria stops working. After that, coagulation is carried out to turn yogurt to a more solid state. The mixture is mixed at 5 degrees Celsius. Finally, the flavoring and fruits are added into the yogurt and are packaged.
Wow, this is so cool. We can even eat these bacteria that are still alive in the yogurt. This is why they are also called as life cultures.
Yes, and not to worry, as they help to improve your lactose digestion and improve your gut immune system. That keeps you healthy, as they swim into your digestion system when you drink it. In other words, they are probiotics, which will fight away those bad bacteria.
Do you know? Bacteria can make tasty foods too? Now, let us see what fermented foods are. Since a long time ago, humans already created foods, such as cheese, pickles, soy sauce, and vinegar, through a process called fermentation, which employs the use of good bacteria.
Throughout the process, the microorganisms will break down the food components that are present into other components. This will give the fermented food a new look and unique appearance. But don't worry, as these bacteria are safe to consume and they make the food taste even better. Yes, there are more. Certain bacteria are widely applied in the bioprocess technology, as they are able to grow very fast under ideal conditions, in which they are able to double their number in a short period of time. Therefore, these bacteria are used to be genetically modified to produce more useful products to be used in the pharmaceutical industry. So, in genetic modification, scientists manipulate bacterial cells to grow and obtain protein of interest to produce desired products. For example, insulin, in large quantities. They use the recombinant bacteria to produce insulin that is widely used for the treatment of diabetic patients.
Other than food products, bacteria are also used in some industries to produce enzymes. And these enzymes can help in the production of various products, such as detergents, shampoo, and even cosmetic products. These products increase the quality of our lives.
That's not all. Good bacteria also help to clean up the environment. Every year, 8 million metric tons of plastics are thrown into the ocean. Luckily, there are certain bacteria that are capable of breaking down plastic, as it consumes polyethylene terephthalate, PET, which is the main component of plastic. As most of the plastic wastes are present in soil and water, some microbiologists are currently working on modifying the genes of the bacteria that make them survive in those areas. In addition, some bacteria can also clean up oil spillage in the ocean by feeding on the large quantities of oil.
See? Bacteria helps humans in so many ways. This is why humans might not survive without those bacteria.
Yes, you are right. The good, bad, and ugly bacteria coexist together to build a pleasant environment and flourish the living things on this planet.
Yeah, so let's stop thinking that bacteria only bring the bad stuff. There are many good bacteria out there, just like our friends, that provide support to humans in many aspects.
Oh well, it's time for us to go now. Thank you for watching.